I like when it gets kind of technical in terms of genre. And I like all the language, and I like all the kind of the ideas, and I like speaking the stuff about the history of Frankenstein's creature. It's the same with vampire movies. I love it when it gets technical, when the kind of the legend becomes specific and quite complicated. So it's quite good fun to speak all that stuff. It's been great working with everybody. Everyone's been, you know, exemplary and very nice, and no, it's all been pretty cool. When I read I, Frankenstein for the first time, it was a very good impression. It's a really, really tight, good script, and good scripts are quite rare in any genre. And it's a brilliant story. And, you know, it's a kind of war film, romantic film. It's kind of got all the universal themes contained within it. And my impression was extremely favorable. I, Frankenstein suggests that the creature from Frankenstein, the original novel, has wandered the world for the last 200 years, having killed or effectively killed Dr. Frankenstein. He didn't actually kill him. Dr. Frankenstein sort of killed himself by following him into the Arctic wastes and dying of frostbite. But the creature has lived on, and who knew that the creature could live for hundreds of years, but it turns out it could live long enough to wander into the contemporary world, where it becomes embroiled in this war between the gargoyles, who are good, surprisingly, and the demons, who are deeply not. Stuart is absolutely exemplary. He's been, he wrote the script, which already endears me to him because it's such a successful job. And he really knows his stuff, and he really knows the genre. And he's very, he's very sharp on the performance. He's just been great, you know, and he's very courteous and very friendly. And more than perhaps anything, or not more than anything, but as well, he is, extremely enthusiastic, which is contagious and refreshing and very cool.